Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2207, insert two decimals. I got this question in Atlanta, and I love this question because I remember the very first time, I was probably 6 or 7, my parents went over to their friend's house, and their friends owned the local gas station in town, right? And so in the home office in their house was this amazing machine, the first time I'd ever seen anything like it. It was a old adding machine, right, with the tape. And I remember there was a switch there, this amazing switch, that when you click that switch, it would automatically insert a decimal point. So if you type 12345, it would enter 12345. All right. And so I was in Atlanta and someone asked me the question, said, "Hey, you know, how can we do that? How can we type 12345 and have it change to 123.45?" And I knew there's a setting in Excel to do this. It's under Excel Options, Advanced, Second Choice. Automatically insert a decimal point. So File, Options, go to Advanced. Advanced is usually you have to scroll all the way down. There's 100 miles of stuff here. I'm just going to automatically insert a decimal point, leave it at two places, click OK, and then I type 12345, and bam, it's 123.45. I ran into a guy up at the VFW in Ohio who used this for a different thing. He File, Options, he was always entering something with 6 decimal places. Some sort of measurement. So 4, 5, 6, like this, and he would type 12345, and it would become a decimal. Let's increase the number of decimal places there so we can see it. And then if it was a measurement like where it was not all the digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, it would automatically insert extra spaces. All right, so really cool thing. Now, the question that came up in Atlanta, though, is, well, hey, can we make this happen in just one range? And no, this is a global thing, right? So once you change that setting, it's going to happen in all cells, all sheets, until you go change it back. So I guess, you know, the answer is just use it while you have to key a bunch of numbers in, and then when you're done keying numbers, then, you know, you come in and turn it off like that. Still a cool way to go. Well, hey, check out my new book, Mr. Excel Live, the 50 Work Greatest Tips of All Time. Click that I in the top right-hand corner for more information. Whoa, hang on a second. Hold the phone. Did you see that tooltip? File, Options, Advanced. And when I happened to hover there, they said choose a number between minus 300 and 300, which seems to indicate that we can automatically insert a decimal point. And if we go to minus 3, that will mean that I can enter numbers. If it's 123,000, I can just enter 123, and they should enter it as 123,000, like that. How cool is that? All right, it goes both ways. Just like the round function does, you can specify 2 for 2 digits after the decimal place, or minus 2 to round to the nearest 100. All right, so even better like that. All right, question from the Atlanta Power Excel Seminar. Is there a way to have Excel always shift my numeric entry so that the last 2 digits appear after the decimal place? Yes. It's File, Options, Advanced, Second Choice. Automatically insert a decimal point. Choose that setting and specify the number of digits. To convert all entries to thousands, you can put a negative number of digits. So 123 becomes 123,000. Put 2 digits and 12345 becomes 123.45. One hassle, you can't do this to just a range. It's global. It's going to work in all cells, all sheets, all workbooks. So turn it on when you need to do some data entry, and then turn it off. To download the workbook from today's video, in case you want to work along, visit the URL in the YouTube description. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.